Assalamualaikum dear students, this is your science teacher Ms. Kanza. Today we are going to start your new chapter, that is chapter 7, forces and their effects. In this chapter we are going to study about what is a force, how do we measure a force, what is a force unit, what are balance forces, what are stretchy materials, what is weight and how do we calculate it, and a resistance. By the end of this chapter you will be able to understand these topics. First, we will discuss about force. Force is a push or pull. We have two types of forces, contact force and distance force. In contact force, two objects are touching each other. In distance force, we can take an example of Earth's gravity. For example, the gravitational pull of Earth holds the moon in orbit at a distinct distance. In this diagram, you can see a bridge which is made up of metal and concrete, and different kinds of forces are acted upon it. These forces are tension, compression, and bending. Now we will discuss these forces individually. First, we are talk about tension. Tension causes stretching. Compression makes the object shorter. Bending causes object to move in opposite direction. Forces can make any object to change its speed, to change its direction, and it can also stop a moving object. Measuring forces. We can measure force by a force meter. It has a spring inside. The larger the force of weight of any object, the more will the spring stretches. Now we will talk about the unit of force. We measure forces in unit, which is called Newton. Newton is named after a famous scientist, Sir Isaac Newton, who discovered the force of gravity. A force meter is often called a Newton meter. Next, we will talk about why do things float. If we notice that when we place an object in water, it does not drown but it floats. There was a famous philosopher Archimedes who noticed this about 2000 years ago. If we take an example of this diagram, It shows that we place a metal brick which weight is about 20 Newton in water and it starts to float. There is a metal rod attached to it which is taking or pushing the metal block upward. This upward force is called upthrust. This shows that the upthrust on this metal block is greater than that of its actual weight. It means that it will take an extra force or greater force to take the metal block outside the water. The more the weight of an object, the more pressure will be applied or more force will be applied to take it out of the water. The upward force or that pressure is called upthrust. Next topic which we will discuss is about balance forces. If we take an example of this boat, it is floating in the water. This is possible because of upthrust on the hull which balances the weight of the boat. Hull basically is a part of a ship which covers the ship's surfaces and prevent it from rusting. Now we will going to read this. It is upthrust that keeps a boat afloat. A floating boat displaces a large volume of water. This water provides enough upthrust on the hull to balance the weight of the boat pushing downwards. Now we will discuss about density. Density or mass are same, which means weight. We calculate the density by using this formula. Density is equals to mass over volume. The unit for density are ग्राम पर सेंटीमीटर क्यूब और किलोग्राम पर मीटर क्यूब. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वाटर हैज़ अ डेंसिटी ऑफ अबाउट 1 ग्राम पर सेंटीमीटर क्यूब. एनी ऑब्जेक्ट लेसर देन दिस डेंसिटी विल फ्लोट, एंड एनी ऑब्जेक्ट विच हैज़ मोर डेंसिटी, इट मीन्स मोर वेट देन दिस, विल सिंक इन वाटर, मीन्स इट विल ड्रोन इन द वाटर, इट विल नेवर फ्लोट. Okay students, now you will be able to understand about forces, its unit, why do objects float, what are the balance forces, and about density. Now we will discuss about elasticity. Our next topic is stretchy materials. First we are going to read this. Forces can cause materials to stretch. When the forces are removed, the material may spring back to its original length. We call this elasticity. Basically, elasticity, it is a force which causes an object to stretch, and more the force are removed, and once the forces are removed, the object often came back to its original length. This is called elasticity. For example, a rubber band can be stretched to several times its length, but it will still return to its original size when released. Rubber is a very elastic material. If you take an example of a metal wire, we also stretch it and it springs back to its shape. But if the forces are small, however, if the forces are too large, the wire will go beyond the elastic limit and it will be left permanently stretched. It means if we stretch a wire and we put extra force, then the wire will go beyond its elastic limit and be left permanently stretched and will not go back to its shape again. Okay, now we will talk about springs. Everyone is familiar about with the spring, that what actually a spring is. Everyone has shown once in a life that what is a spring is and how it is look and what are its look. Basically, springs are very useful because they stretch and spring back evenly. If we take an example of this graph, in this graph, it is shown that we are stretching a spring by acting forces on it by 1 Newton, 2 Newton, 3 Newton and 4 Newton. But on a certain limit, if we apply more force on it beyond 4 Newton, it will stretch but it will lose its shape. Like this. It means it will not remain same as it was. It will lose its shape. It will stretch, but it will lose its shape. It means it will be opened. It will never go back to its shape once it was stretched beyond its elastic limit. Okay, I'm going to repeat what we have studied up till now. First, we studied about the force, that what is a force. Basically, force is a movement, be it push or pull. We have two types of forces. One is contact and other one is distance. In contact forces, two objects are touching each other. And in the distance forces, the forces we take an example of gravity. Then we talk about forces can act in three ways. First in tension, then compression, and then bending. Tension will cause stretching, compression makes the object shorter, and bending will make an object move in an opposite direction. Then we study that forces can make any object to change their speed, to change their direction, and it can also stop a moving object. Then we study about the measuring force. We measure the force by the help of force meter. This force meter is also called Newton meter. It is called Newton meter because of a very famous scientist, Sir Isaac Newton, who discovered the force gravity. Everyone is familiar about the word gravity. Gravity basically, it's a force of attraction of our Earth. Then we discuss that why do the things float in the water and why they are not drowned. According to a famous philosopher who named Archimedes, 2000 years ago, he suggested that the object had not really lost weight, but that it was the water pushing up on it that made it seem as if it had. If we take this diagram as an example, it clearly shown that it has a metal block inside it in the water, and there is a metal rod attached to it. And this metal rod is trying to push or take the metal block out of it. And the pressure which is applying upward is called upthrust. No matter how much the weight we put into water, it will take 2 times greater pressure to take the object out of the water because of the upthrust force. Then we talk about the balance forces. We said that the upthrust force on the, if we take an example of this boat, we said that the upthrust force will keep a boat afloat. A floating boat displaces a large volume of water. This water provides enough upthrust on the hull to balance the weight of the boat pushing downward. I told you about the hull. What is a hull? Basically, hull is a piece of a boat which is like a preventive measure which prevent the boat from rusting. Then we talk about the density. Basically, density or mass are the same thing, which means weight. And we calculate the density by using this formula. Density is equals to mass over volume. The unit of density are gram per centimeter cube or kilogram per meter cube. For example, if we take an example of water and we estimated its density 1 gram by centimeter cube, the object having density less than this will float, and any object which will have a density more than this or greater than this will sink in water. It means it will drown in water. It will not be able to float. Then we talk about the stretchy materials. We take an example of elastic or rubber bands. Rubber bands or elastic are a very stretchy materials. Once they stretch and we extract the force or remove the force, it will go back to its actual shape. But if we take an example of a wire and if we stretch it, it will go back to its remaining shape, its exact shape, but not in every case. It means if we apply too much force, the wire will stretch, but it will never go back to its shapes again. It means if we take an example of spring, we can stretch a spring, but if we stretch it more than its elastic capacity, it will never go back in its actual shape. If we take an example from this graph, in this graph, in the left side, there is 0 to 60 extensions in millimeter are written, and from 0 to 5, load in Newton is written. And we have shown that we have applied about 4 Newton of weight on this spring. But there is a dot or which is called as limit of Hooke's law. Limit of Hooke's law dictate that after this limit, if we keep on stretching this spring, it will never go back on its actual size or its actual shape again, because we stretch it more than its elastic capacity. Okay, students, I hope that you will able to understand this topic. The remaining topic of this chapter we will inshallah discuss in this next video. Thank you for watching. Take care. Allah Hafiz.